Welcome back to this video series on the topic of fun and factorization. In this video, we'll be having all sorts of fun as we go about factorizing some rather trickier looking algebraic expressions. Look at example A over here. We have 2 multiplied by x minus 7 plus x multiplied by x minus 7. We have an expression that looks rather tricky compared to what we've been doing in the past. However, what we're going to find is that the distance between us and success in this particular problem, at least, is rather short, much shorter than what it has been in the previous questions. The reason I say that is if we take a closer look at what we have in this expression here across both of the terms, we have a 2 and an x minus 7 already in brackets. Then for the second term, we have an x multiplied by an x minus 7 also already in brackets. Now, if we have a look, they're both in common, and therefore, if they're both in common, we can sort of pull them out like so. So the factorization process has already started. Now, next step is we need to have a look at what we're leaving behind. In the first term, we leave behind a 2, the operation is plus, and in the second term, we leave behind an x. And therefore, the factorization of 2 multiplied by x minus 7 plus x multiplied by x minus 7 is simply x minus 7 multiplied by 2 plus x. Easy done. Now, example B here, we have a similar situation. However, the distance between us and success is an extra step away. Now, if we have a look at the two terms, we have a 5 multiplied by y plus 2 minus a 2y plus 4. What you're going to notice here is at this point in time, there's nothing in common. So what we're going to do to begin with is we're going to factorize this second term. Factorizing the second term, our first term is unchanged, I should say. But our second term, notice how we've got a 2y and a 4 in here. The factors of 4 are 2 and 2. So what that means is that we can break this down into a 2y plus 2 times 2. And we can pull out the 2 over here and the 2 here. Pulling the 2 out, we're left with a y plus 2. And then, taking a closer look at what we have in common, we've got a y plus 2 and we've got a y plus 2. Factorizing this, we're going to get a y plus 2, like so. And what we leave behind is in open brackets, we have a 5. The operation is negative and the left behind value is 2. So the factorization of 5y plus 2 and minus 2y plus 4 is going to be y plus 2 multiplied by 5 minus 2. Now, we can go one step further in this, in that if you look at what we have inside of here, it's a 5 minus 2. They're two numbers. We can actually collect these like terms. So we can go y plus 2, and then 5 minus 2 is going to be 3. And therefore, rewriting this out, we get 3y plus 2. And therefore, we are done. So we're able to go one more step than I was expecting here. So not bad. All right. Example C. We have something that looks rather troubling. We have z plus 2 all squared plus 2z plus 4. What we are going to do here is we're going to sort of open up this z plus 2 to make it look a little bit clearer. I'm not going to expand, but I'm going to sort of decompress it. Now the plus 2 or the squared at the top simply means that there's two copies of z plus 2. And then over on the right here, we still have a 2z plus 4. Now one way we can rewrite this 2z plus 4 is we throw in some imaginary brackets here and here and here, and then we go back and we change this 4 to a 2 multiplied by 2. What you're going to see is that we're able to factorize for the 2 and the 2 here. Having done that, we're going to be able to pull the 2 out the front, and then we're left with a z plus 2 over here. Now, second step is we have to have a look at what factors we have in common. In the first one, we have a z plus 2, and in the second one, we have a z plus 2 as well. Notice I'm only taking one z plus 2 from the first term, and the reason for that is because if I take one here, I'm only allowed to take one here. I only have a single one on the right, so I can't take both on the left. So, rewriting this out, our first factor is going to be z plus 2. And then what we leave behind is a z plus 2. And we can pretend that's still in brackets, followed by a plus operation and a 2. Now, these lighter blue brackets over here, there's no reason we have to keep these open because it's not necessarily a factor. It's simply a term inside the bigger brackets. So those lighter blue brackets can just be ignored. By ignoring those, we're going to get z plus 2 plus 2. And we can simply collect like terms inside there. So that will become z, and the plus 2s are going to become plus 4. And thus, we have factorized z plus 2 squared plus 2z plus 4 down to z plus 2 multiplied by z plus 4. So in conclusion, what we had a look at in this video was how we can factorize some trickier algebraic expressions. Trickier being that it's not necessarily new concepts, but rather the factors themselves are composed of terms inside themselves. But we can simply grab the factors like we've been doing before. Now, this particular subject matter here and techniques I've showcased here, they're going to take a little bit of time to be able to build up such that you become proficient at identifying by inspection when you have factors like this. But if you do enough practice, then it will come naturally over time.